Yeah, so I work for Happiest Minds. I work with the data science and AI ML team here. And we have a decent sized team for AI ML and specific to this area in Happiest Minds. So my work in this team has been into multiple areas and researching the same space, being it chatbot or NLP or maybe visual analytics. So we have deal in this area specifically. And yeah, I think the decent size team is what is growing this part in our organization. Yeah, the sessions were amazing actually. They're quite interesting. I mean, there are some quite deep sessions which we actually went into the coding and we actually get to see some code. That's good for us all, I mean, us all developers, right? So yeah, and apart from that, I mean, my session was particularly on analyzing the quality of product descriptions. So if you go to all the websites, Amazon, Flipkart, you'll get product descriptions. So you'll read through them and buy some product. It's not the first thing that you'll see. You'll see a photograph of a phone, of a nice photograph of a phone. Then you'll go through the description. So that is where my talk was about, analyzing the specific idea of how a product description has been written and giving it a score so that the copywriters can amend and do better in that aspect. Yeah. I think I spoke about the topic in a very limited scope, but the scope of the topic is huge. I mean, you can apply the same algorithms which I showed to different areas. You can apply the same algorithms towards political campaigns, maybe for India or abroad. You can apply it same to the legal tech as well, legal industries as well. So, I mean, the areas where it can be used is enough, are sufficient. I think they should do a sufficient amount of research and read the white paper that I've written and then come up with huge ideas and maybe present it next year. I think the trends have been quite promising because now people are getting specifics into the techniques. Initially, it was pretty high level. People used to talk about it, but nobody knows how to do it. So now we are getting something pretty specific and interesting use cases. For example, we are working for a customer in accounting and taxation area. So their use case, which we have presented, is quite interesting. We have to go through the policy documents, through a lot of documentation, and give them useful insights. If somebody asks something, we have to literally go through hundreds and thousands of documents and give them the right answer. So I think now things are getting pretty specific, and now is where the challenge starts. I think 3 to 4 years back, most of the startups and things that we have seen were happening in US on the coastal region, right? So most of the stuff was happening in that area. But I think now, yes, the focus is shifting towards India, specifically Bangalore being the hub of IT in India. So yeah, I think there is a lot of scope in that, and we are doing much more than what people in other countries per se were doing at that time. Yeah, so we are getting into specifics and we have people to do that, especially being a most populist country. We have a decent population to support it. Correct. I think scalability is a problem area, is a pain point for sure. Any model that you create is going to take tons of time to run and finally deploy something anywhere in a production environment. So that is a headache that we've seen with almost all the customers. So the idea is you scale slowly. You don't get into the final production phase at the immediate instant, right? You get into a scalability mode on a test-by-test basis. You don't get into the full-fledged platform. You first do A to B testing. You first do small stages of testing and then apply some auto-scaling techniques also so that you can actually achieve something which is efficient in terms of money also. No, I think you are right in saying whatever you said about the gender bias. I mean, the root cause actually lies in the people who are doing it. I mean, unless people change, things are not going to change. Things are changing now because more women are in tech and they are making their places. They're going to a lot of places in tech as well. But yeah, I think it is going to take some time for things that have been done in past to amend those as well, for sure. Yeah, it'll take time. I think for the conference, to be specific and just one word, one simple word, it was quite interesting. And yeah, it was quite interesting. It was what I expected it to be, and it actually exceeded what I expected.